The Democrats now control the White House and Congress, and that means get ready for some crazy new taxes. Hey, over 81 million people voted for it, right? On today's video, I'm gonna tell you about the dumbest and most insane new tax that will kill jobs and businesses and cause the stock market to crash, and it will surely affect you. Let's go. Hey, what's up, you guys? I am Dima, and if you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by. If you're already a subscriber, I really appreciate your support. On this channel, I simplify real estate, business, and finance for you so that you can make great decisions in your life, and hopefully, I entertain you in the process. By the way, I am almost through with this cold that's been bugging me for about a week, so I'm still a little bit stuffed up. It's not the C word, it's just a little cold. Anyhow, there are some wacky proposals coming out of Washington these days, now that our executive and legislative branches are controlled by the left. But none are dumber and more insane than the mark-to-market method of taxing capital gains that I'm going to tell you about today. I'm also going to tell you how this is going to directly affect you, regardless of how much money you make, regardless of your net worth, and I'll also tell you what you can do about it. So make sure you stay until the end of the video. Now, I previously made a video about the introduction of a similar tax in California as part of a bigger bill to solve homelessness in the state. You could check out that full video right over here. And by the way, if you like low taxes and you like low regulations like me, do me a favor and hit the like button on this video so YouTube shows it to more people and we can spread the message all over the world. In all seriousness though, guys, it really does help support my channel and it's absolutely free. So hit the like button right now. All right, you guys, so Senator Ron Wyden, a Democrat from Oregon, the very intelligent Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, and Representative Jan Schakowsky, a Democrat from Illinois, all support the introduction of a federal mark-to-market method of taxing unrealized capital gains, all in the name of solving the nation's income equity gap. By the way, guys, I want to take a quick time out to tell you that I am in favor of solving the nation's income equity gap, so don't get me wrong on this video. However, the way they're trying to do it is really nuts. Let's talk about it. Currently, the way that capital gains taxes work is that when you buy an asset and then it appreciates over time, you only pay taxes on the gain when you sell that asset. That makes common sense, right, you guys? The government shouldn't force you to pay taxes on profit that you haven't even made, should they? Let me give you an example of how this works. Let's say you click the link below in the description, you open an account with Swan Bitcoin, since Bitcoin's all the rage, you get your 10 bucks of free Bitcoin in the process, and you start buying some Bitcoin because you know it's gonna be worth $1 million soon, right? P.S. That's not a guarantee. I'm only saying that for entertainment purposes. Anyhow, when it's time to file your tax returns next year, let's say that you ended up buying one Bitcoin for the average price of $53,000, which is around where it's trading today. And then at the end of the year, let's just say hypothetically, for example only, it's worth $100,000. Now you haven't sold it yet, but the difference, that $47,000, is your unrealized capital gains. Now under the current system, of course you wouldn't pay taxes on it because it's just sitting there. You haven't sold it, you haven't realized a gain on it. But with a mark-to-market system, you would owe tax on that unrealized gain even if you don't sell the Bitcoin. Not only that, these politicians want to tax capital gains at ordinary income tax levels. So if the top tax bracket is increased to 39.6%, like Joe Biden and some of these other Democrats want to do, let's do the math, guys. $47,000 times 39.6% equals $18,612. And that's how much you would have to pay the IRS on your Bitcoin profit, even if you don't sell it. Now, what if you don't have the cash? Not their problem. You'd have to figure something out, like maybe sell some of that Bitcoin to pay the tax. And if that's not enough, they also want to add what's called a look-back interest charge that would be imposed on gains from non-publicly traded assets like closely held businesses, investment real estate, art, collectibles, stuff like that, upon an event like a sale. So they'd go all the way back and make you pay interest on all the taxes that you didn't pay while it appreciated every single year. If you're thinking that this is all totally dumb and completely insane, well, I'm with you. Later in this video, I'll tell you what you can actually do about it. But first, the question I want to answer is whether this will affect you. The short answer is that it's a little unclear as to who will be directly affected and whether there will be a minimum threshold for income or assets for a mark-to-market system to apply. However, I will tell you that regardless of how much money you make, regardless of your net worth, this type of ridiculous proposal disincentivizes saving and investing, meaning people are less likely to buy stocks, and it also greatly increases the administrative burden on the taxing authority. The Tax Foundation, an independent tax policy nonprofit, says that overall, moving to a mark-to-market system without lowering capital gains tax rates would increase the tax burden, leading to a reduction in income. But these politicians not only want to implement this mark-to-market system, they also want to raise capital gains taxes to ordinary income levels. So they want it both ways. Now you might be thinking, has this system ever been tried anywhere else? And how did it work out? We should look somewhere else to see examples. Well, it actually has been tried in other countries, you guys. And guess what? It failed miserably for the same reasons. It increases the administrative burden, it reduces the incentive to save, and it doesn't actually accomplish the set out goal of reducing income inequality. By the way, if the proposal excludes publicly traded assets like stocks in order not to increase the administrative burden, well, then people will simply move to assets that are not publicly traded, resulting in a shift away from US securities. Yeah, probably not a good thing either. So the next question is, of course, what can you and I do about it? Well, we can vote. And when you do vote, vote for politicians that offer common sense approaches and solutions to fix the issues plaguing the country, not these radical policies that don't work. To me, it doesn't matter if someone's a Democrat, a Republican, an independent, I don't really care. Just introduce common sense policies that actually do what you want them to do and solve the problems that are important. And while we're at it, why don't we fix our voting system? It can't be that hard to require voter ID and make sure that all votes are legally cast. I'm not saying that there was anything wrong with the 2020 election, but why even open this up for discussion? Surely we can come up with a system that works really well so that everyone can be confident in our elections. So what do you think about this proposal, guys? Let me know in the comments below. One of my favorite things about this YouTube channel is reading and responding to your comments, and I look forward to chatting with you directly. Be sure to follow me on all of your favorite social channels. Text me so that you know about my next giveaway and you can communicate with me directly. And get that $10 of free Bitcoin by clicking the link below. Thanks again for tuning in, and I'll catch you on the next video.